Green Kratom. I am starting Green Kratom for the next 30 days, and I'm going to actually share what it's like and how the effects are. I am always struggling with MDD. It's major depressive disorder. SSRIs, which are antidepressants, typically don't work for me. They usually either make me really lethargic or they actually put me in a suicidal state of mind. So I've always experimented and trial and erred some to see what else is out there that may help me with my depression and share what it's like. So for the next 30 days, I'm actually doing this right here, which is Green Kratom. And I'll explain it to you. If you're new to my channel, hit the like and subscribe button. My name is Eric. I'm not a counselor, doctor, therapist. I'm none of that. I'm diagnosed with ADHD, PTSD, GAD, and MDD. Those are my diagnoses. I lost a wife and a father to suicide. I'm a recovering cocaine and alcoholic addict. And I've struggled a lot in the past. I go to therapy. I take meds. I've self-harmed before. I struggle with body image. So I always am looking out there for different tools and different things that I can use to help. And Kratom is one of those that, if you're not aware of it, there's different strains of it. There's white Kratom, there's green Kratom, and there's red Kratom. Green Kratom is between white and red, is the easiest way I guess you could put it. It is supposed to enhance your mood and enhance your energy and also have a little bit of pain relief. Now, I'm not in any kind of pain, so I'm not taking it for those purposes. I'm going after essentially the mood, the of what it can do, how hopefully to just my mindset, because I do have ups and downs. When you struggle with major depressive disorder, I mean, your depression hits in waves and it hits hard, and it will last for periods of time where you don't want to get out of bed, and every day becomes a fight. Always, again, looking for tools on that. So I've done a lot with white Kratom. I did white Kratom for 30 days. It helped, but it made me lethargic in a sense. I've shared videos about the white Kratom experience. So I wanted to go through the different strands and just see if one of them makes a difference. Now, I only do them for 30 days. Yes, I am a recovering addict. Yes, Kratom is a classified drug in three states out there, or actually four states out there, I apologize. Everywhere else, it is legal. And what Kratom is it is a root. It's in Indonesia that has benefits to it, and they are benefits. I know people that have been able to get off of heroin and opiates with the help of red Kratom, but I also know that it has hurt other people out there too. I have one good friend of mine that ended up getting on Suboxone because he tried to get off of opiates the way of red Kratom and actually made it a lot worse. And next thing I know, he's on Suboxone. He's getting the help that he needs to then taper off of that. So that is the main reason I only go 30 days. And I also let people in my life know that, hey, I am taking this, it's not even a medication, but I'm taking this route to experiment with it, to trial and error with it. So if you notice any changes in me, please let me know, because it is something I'm very, very cautious about. Now, the Kratom that I get, and I'll explain it to you, this is green Kratom here. And I know it looks a little funky because of the bottle it's in. I get Kratom usually from head shops. That's where I got the last one at. That's where I got this one at, and even the red Kratom. And the reason I get it at smoke shops, head shops, whatever you want to call it, is just because usually the people there have taken it. They can tell me a lot about it. I can get it in a vitamin store. And these are the capsules. I did not go with the powder, and here's why. Now, the capsules are not as potent or as effective, I've heard people say, as what the powder is. So that is one of the reasons that I do the capsules. Now, the capsules, I'll take four in the morning. I'll take four in the afternoon. And the reason I don't do the powder is because capsules I can measure. My brain works in numbers and mathematics. So if I know, okay, four capsules, I'm not worried about taking too much or too little, and I can actually measure out my dosage. So that's the reason I went with the capsules. I know a lot of people that go strictly with the powder itself, and it is grinded up roots. And I can tell you this, I know that there is an effect from Kratom because I felt it. I actually felt a little bit of a detox from the white Kratom. So I may experience even a detox from the green Kratom. For 30 days though, I am gonna try it, and I will share, you know, pretty much kind of every week of what it's like, because the more that we do share what we're going through and experiences that we're going through, the more that it helps somebody out there a little less with their trial and error, gets them the help that they need. And it's hard to even have non-judgment when it comes to stuff like this, because things like even psychedelics are known and scientifically proven to help actually people with anxiety, yet it's something that is illegal. I know people out there that have tried, you know, different things, like when it comes to weed. I mean, if I could smoke weed instead of taking a benzo, I would. But unfortunately, even no matter what strain of weed I've tried, whether it's sativa, indica, whether I'm going glass, shattered, whatever types of wax there are out there, just even a sticks pen, whatever it is, or Stizzy pen, excuse me, it gives me just a massive paranoia, and I don't like it. And so I'd rather stick with the benzos, because I do take roughly about 2 milligrams of Xanax a month when the anxiety gets too much. So I'm hoping that the green kratom actually helps me with my mood. I'm hoping that it helps me with the energy level a little bit. Again, not keen. I don't need the pain. I mean, white kratom is really designed for energy and mood. Green kratom is for energy, mood, and pain. And then red kratom is for pain, energy, and mood. So, I mean, that's why green kratom is pretty much kind of defined as in the middle. So we'll see how it actually ends up working, because today I've already taken the first dose of it. I haven't made it through the full day yet. And last time I took it, I didn't really notice the effects, I would say, until probably about 4 or 5 days into it. Now, I know that with, like, even when you go to medications or anything like that, they're like, you know, you got to give it 30 days. You got to give it 30 days. I'm a firm believer, again, not a doctor, not a counselor, none of that. But I'm a firm believer that you start to feel how a medication is going to affect you within about the first 7 days that you're taking it. You usually won't feel any effects the first day because your body is just kind of absorbing it. So I don't really expect too much the first day here. I will actually do another video of how this first day has went and kind of what I did through my day. Just the trying what it is like, I am very, very curious. I don't know if it really matters the brand of kratom that you get. I've gotten a lot of different people that have reached out to me, told me that this is a lifesaver. But the funny part is so many people reach out to me and told me that they just do the powder form and mix it with water. Typically with kratom, you can do it in the capsule forms like I am doing, or you get the powder. And I know people that say it tastes horrible, so they put the powder on their tongue and like chug water or chug something after it. I also know people that will take it and mix it into a drink and then drink it. I'm not a big fan of trying to mix stuff though. It's not one of those that I want to know that it's precise in the same amount nonstop. So again, that's why I'm going with the capsules. I'm curious. I'm hoping that it works. Like, the big thing that I hope that it does is that it does help with my mood and my energy. The thing with kratom, I know a lot of people are also always afraid of kratom or afraid of a lot of different things because of the drug tests and stuff that are out there. Kratom doesn't show up in the drug test. Just like if you're smoking weed, yeah, that's going to show up. If you're on Adderall, even, that's going to show up. Kratom is something that's not going to show up. It's not something that's necessarily tested for. I have to dig in a little bit more and find out a little bit more research on it to find out if the four states that actually have it classified as the same type of drug as heroin, if they actually drug test for it and if it is detectable. The thing with the red kratom is that's the one that a lot of people have, you know, been really afraid of or really brought up the controversy, just because the red kratom does hit some of those same receptors. If you didn't know, opiates and heroin, the reason that those addictions are so strong, going through the recovery process of it or trying to get sober from it is very, very painful because your brain has natural receptors that they bond to. Opiates and heroin are very similar. That's why a lot of opiate addicts, if they can't get the pills anymore, they're switching over to heroin because it's cheaper, more readily available. The red kratom actually hits those same receptors. So the red kratom is the one that I'm actually a little bit scared about doing, just because I'm not sure if I'm going to actually really hit a detox from that one, because I did hit a detox from the white kratom and it wasn't a massive like detox or anything. I didn't notice any like massive withdrawals of shaking, you know, temperature change, sweats, any of that stuff. But I did notice it affected how I went to the bathroom, which I noticed when I got sober from alcohol and cocaine, my bowel movements and how I shit took a big difference. So I'm really curious to see how the kratom does. And if it works, it works. And that's awesome. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. And if it gets to the point that I need to stop it, I'm going to stop it. But that is part of trial and error. And if you're scared, I run into so many people that are scared to try medication and they're scared. I can tell you this, man, Adderall saved my life, because without my Adderall, I end up self-medicating and I self-medicate the wrong ways and it becomes very destructive. Next thing you know, I can't control my drinking. I can't control my cocaine usage. I've done videos on how I've blown $60,000, $70,000 worth of money in, you know, just a matter of months on cocaine and alcohol. And I don't, that's not what life is about, trying to self-medicate yourself. When it comes down to the medication, if you find the right one after trial and error, it makes a huge difference. And that's the whole thing that everyone has to remember, is that it is trial and error. I never get my hopes up when I try something new, because when I was first diagnosed ADD and then later on ADHD, I was first prescribed Ritalin and it worked, but it dropped me too quickly. And so then I had to go to Adderall. Then I tried Adderall XR. Then I went back to Adderall. Then I tried different dosage amounts of Adderall. And it took me a while to get the right amount down. But once I did, my God, life has become amazing. And that was the whole point of trial and error. Now you can do the swab test out there. If you didn't know, there are swab tests out there to see how you react and how different medications will metabolize in your body to help with that trial and error process. So you can always talk to your therapist about one of those. So green kratom, here we go. This stuff's called Blue Magic. That's the only thing I don't like about like the kratom and going to the head shops. It's Blue Magic. I mean, come on. Can't you name it something else? Like, I don't know, green kratom. But it's Blue Magic. There is a warning on here. Do not use if you are pregnant or nursing. It is illegal to possess kratom if under 18 years of age. Consult a healthcare professional before using. Do not combine with alcohol or medication, which I am actually combining it with medication, so I'll be curious to see how that works. Consult a doctor prior to usage if you have any heart disease, liver disorder, high blood pressure, medical condition, or take medicine. So we're going to see how this does, and hopefully I get the positive benefits from it and none of the negative benefits from it. And you guys will get to experience and see the whole thing with me. So let's do this together. If you're new again to my channel, I'd love to have you comment down below how Kratom has maybe helped you. Hit that like and subscribe button. I'm going to be sharing on this a lot here for the next coming months. Just sharing all of my experiences with this as I go through the trial and error process. Because the more that we share our experiences and the more that we share what we've been through, the more that it helps make sure that nobody goes through life alone. And it helps a lot with that trial and error process. I mean, if you click the description down below, you'll see links to all my different social medias. You'll see links to my TikTok, everything else, because I am one of the larger mental health advocates out there. And that's what it's about. It's about people helping people through all the experiences, tools, and resources that we have so that nobody goes it alone. I mean, my goal is to bridge the gap between therapy and a crisis hotline. I have a link down below to the mental health Discord community. It's free peer-to-peer support. I have links down below to things on Amazon like fidget cubes, fidget spinners, things that I use for my anxiety every single day to help fight through. Even have a link down below to BetterHelp because again, if you're not in therapy and you've never tried therapy before, you're afraid of a therapist, believe me, it makes a difference. Therapy makes a difference. But again, a trial and error to find the right therapist for you and the right type of therapy for you. And you got this. Life is a journey and it's a battle sometimes, but it's one that you're worth and the one that you got. So remember that you're not alone. I mean, you're a BAMF. You're a badass motherfucker. You made it through 100% of your worst days to make it through to today. And today, you got this.